morning, everyone. My name is Xinyue Peng. I'm a fifth year PhD student in chemical engineering. Today, I'm going to talk about storing solar energy with chemistry. People in the world need energy, and all the energy we need in a year is delivered to the Earth by the sun in 1 hour. So take a guess, what percent of our electricity today is generated from solar energy? 40? 20? 10? The answer is none of the above. It's only 1%. Why we don't take advantage of this abundant renewable resource? Because there are many challenges of using solar. First, the sun only shines during the day, so we need to store a lot of energy for the night. Second, the sun shines more at deserts than cities like Madison, so we need to store and transport the energy from one place to another. Well, you may say, we can use batteries, but they are too expensive and heavy to transport. So our question is, can we find a new way to store energy that is cheaper and lighter? As a chemical engineer, I'm working on storing solar energy in chemical bonds. We are looking for a special type of molecules. When they are exposed to sunlight, their chemical bonds are broken by absorbing energy from the sun. We can then store and transport these separate parts. When we need energy, we just let the parts go back together. When the chemical bonds are reformed, the energy is released. This reversible process can happen over and over again. Sounds great, right? But here is the complication. There are millions of chemicals that are possible to use for storage. How can we know which one is the best? So we can use computer to help us. During my PhD, I developed a computational program to screen out the best candidates from a large chemical database. For any given chemical, our tool can tell us whether this bond breaking is reversible, how strong the bond is, and most importantly, what's the storage cost. Using this screening tool, we have successfully discovered several promising chemicals that can store 5 times more energy than the same weight battery and at a lower price. Imagine one day in the future, all gas stations are replaced by solar stations. Instead of gas, our cars are now run on these special chemicals that harvest solar energy and do not emit CO2. On that day, we are living in a truly sustainable world. Thank you.